eighth trial. There are no signs above the door, explained the prisoner.
Quite true, said the king. The signs were just made, and I haven't had time to put them up yet.
Then how do you expect me to choose? Demanded the prisoner.
Well, here are the signs, replied the king.
This room contains a tiger.
Both rooms contain tigers.
Contain tigers.
That's all well and good, said the prisoner anxiously. For which sign goes on which door?
The king thought a while.
I can even tell you, he said, you can solve this problem without that information.
Only remember, of course, he added, that a lady in the left-hand room means the sign which should be on that door is true, and a tiger in it means the sign should be false, and that the reverse is true for the right-hand room. What is the solution?
So now it becomes a little more complicated. I don't even know which sign goes where.
So we don't go room one, room two, we should go room left and room right.
So yes, what do I do now? Well, it's similar. I really just have more possibilities. Let's see, do you have an idea? What should we do?
I have an idea, but I don't want to force it on you.
If we want to stay close to our strategy that we had, what we can say is, let's still separate room one and room two. I just don't know which sign goes where. So on the one hand, there could be a lady in both. But this room could have, let's number the first one sign one and the second one sign two. This room could have sign one on it, and this room could have sign two on it. Or it could be the other way around. So I have more possibilities. Let's just write down the second scenario. It could be lady tiger. And I have to check either sign combination, sign one and two, or two and one. The top one I number sign one, the bottom one I number sign two. And then we have more. Let's do them over here. Room one, room two. Again, it's not the only way to do it. I'm just looking for the most straightforward way to not have to guess anything. Tiger lady. So this could have sign one and sign two, or sign two and sign one. And tiger, tiger. With sign one, sign two, sign two, sign one. Now, admittedly, if the game gets more and more complicated, then it's going to become tedious to write down all the possible cases and check them all. And I'd have to maybe come up with something fancier, but this is still manageable. Sort of a brute force method by just going through all the possibilities and finding the one that works. Okay, let's check what these signs say. Room one, so I think we now have eight possible combinations. Room one has a lady in sign one. Room two has a lady with sign two. So I know that this should be true. What is it actually? If it has sign one on the door, this room contains a tiger, that's not true. They don't match up, but I don't have to do the rest. Of that first line. This one? Lady with sign two on the door. Both rooms contain tigers. No, that's not true. So I don't even have to worry about these guys. It doesn't matter. They have to all match up, and this one doesn't, so these are all out. Let's check this one. Lady with sign one this room contains a tiger?
No, no it doesn't.
And it's supposed to be true. They don't match. I don't care what happens to room two. It already doesn't match. If it has sign two on it, both rooms contain tigers. No, it's not true either. So none of these are true. Let's go to these possibilities. If there's a tiger in room one, I know it has to be false. With sign one on the door, this room contains a tiger. That's true. So that's not what's happening. If it has sign two on the door, both rooms contain tigers. No, they don't. That's a false statement, and it matches up. Everyone with me? Stop me if it's getting confusing. So, tiger in the room means it should be false? It is. So I have to check this one. Lady in room two means it should be a false statement. What is statement one, or sign one, on room two? Sign one says this room contains a tiger, but it doesn't. It contains a lady. So that seems to all match up. I sense confusion. Let's test these guys. So this one seems to be a yes. We'll check it again. Tiger in this room means it should be false. If it has sign one on it, this room contains a tiger, well, that's a true statement. They don't match up. If it has sign two on it, both rooms contain tigers. That's true as well. And they don't match up. So this is the only one that works. Does that make sense? Any questions? I'm not sure. So remember the rules are, if there's a tiger in the room, room one, then the statement on the door is false. If statement two is on the door, it says, both rooms contain tigers. That is false. It matches. It's supposed to be false, it is false. If there's a lady with the other sign, sign one, the lady in room two means false, should be false. What is it? Well, sign one says this room contains a tiger. That is a false statement, and they match up. You could have very easily argued, well, I'm never going to look at any of this, because there can be a lady in room one. There's a lady in room one. That sign, regardless of which one it is, has to be true. And neither one of them can be true. So this is automatically not ever going to happen. And you can write a little sentence saying that and then go to these guys. Or you can just look at all the possibilities systematically. Any questions? So let's see, what would he pick? He would have to pick room two. And it's true that the signs, it didn't matter which sign goes where, there's still only one possibility. So he would have to pick room two. Room two seems to be the popular one. All right. The third day. Found it, said the king. Again, all the prisoners won. I think tomorrow I'll have three rooms instead of two. I'll put a lady in one room and a tiger in each of the other two rooms. Then we'll see how the prisoners fare. Excellent idea, replied the minister. Your conversation, though flattering, is just a bit on the repetitive side, the king. Excellent, good, replied the minister. The ninth trial. Well, on the third day, the king did his plan. He offered three rooms to choose from, and he explained to the prisoner
that one room contains a lady and the other two contain tigers. Here are the signs. Tigers in this room, ladies in this room, a tiger is in room two. The king explained that at most one of the three signs is true. Which one contains the lady? Now it seems worse that it has three, that we now have three rooms, but the possibilities aren't that much actually. We can easily handle that. Because I know there's only one lady, I just have to find which one it is. So let's do number nine. So now I have room one, room two, and room three. What are my possibilities?
Lady,
tiger, tiger,
tiger,
lady, tiger, 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 lady. So only three possibilities, because I only have one lady. She can only be in one of the three rooms, and the other ones will have tigers. That's not too bad. Now, what is the extra information that I have? At most, one of the three signs is true. So now I just have to check. If a lady is in room one, the sign says, a tiger is in this room. False. A tiger in room two, I'm looking at this possibility, seeing if that is possible. The tiger in room two, well, the statement says, the lady is in this room. That is false as well. Tiger in room three, the statement says, the tiger is in room two. That's true. Before we make a conclusion, let's go through all the possibilities. I only have three, so it's not so bad. Room one. Tiger in the room, the statement says a tiger is in this room. That's true. Lady in room two, the lady is in this room. That's true as well. Room three, the tiger is in room two. No, that's not true. And the last one, tiger in room one, statement says a tiger is in this room. That's true. Room two, tiger in room two, on the statement says a lady is in this room. False. Lady in room three statement says a tiger is in room two. That's true. Which one is actually the case? Which one is actually happening? First one? Not these two? Why not?
Only
up to one can be true. So this is the one. So room one should be the one I choose. All right. Doing well. I will leave the 10th one for you as well, practice. Okay. Any questions so far? In this more whimsical trial, the king explained to the prisoner that one of the three rooms contained the lady, another the tiger, and the third room was empty. The sign on the door of the room containing the lady was true. The
sign on the door of the room which with the tiger was false, and the sign on the door of the empty room could be either true or false. Here are the signs. Room 3 is empty. The tiger is in room 1. This room is empty. Now the prisoner happened to know the lady in question and wished to marry her. Therefore, although the empty room was preferable to the one with the tiger, his first choice was the room with the lady. Which room contains the lady and which room contains the tiger? And then of course, we could easily say which room's empty.
So there's two possibilities to be free.
Sorry?
He has two possibilities to be free as well.
Well, yes. But we're still looking for the room with the lady. So yes, if there's only one, we have to still find the scenario that is true, and then you can pick either one to be safe, yes. But if you want to marry the lady, well, there's only one door to choose. But yes, his odds are a little better.
Perspective of the lady.
Let us see, what do we do here? This is now number 11. Room 1. Room 2. Room 3. What are the possibilities? This is the last one we're doing, so I want you to do most of it. Following our strategy, what are the possibilities? So, a basic strategy is to just run through all the possible combinations of what is behind each of the doors in the rooms, and then see which possibility matches up, agrees with all the information. And what's the information? The information is that the room with the lady is true, the room with the tiger is false, and the empty room can be either. What do I do?
So tiger, lady, empty.
I want to make sure that you can get all the combinations.
Lady, tiger, empty. Empty.
Tiger, lady, empty. Tiger, empty, lady. We got lady, tiger.
How do you know for sure those are the only possibilities?
Well, did he say nothing more?
He Each one is in each room twice. Yes. Let's go with these first. Why not?
Start at the back. Doesn't matter.
I want to check all of them anyway. Statement, the door one says room three is empty. Well, it can be true or false. Doesn't really matter. Room three is empty. That's false. But an empty room can be true or false. So that doesn't tell me much. Room two statement, the tiger is in room one. That is false. Room three statement, this room is empty. That's false. Is this a yes or a no?
No.
Why not?
Because the lady has to always be true.
This one, yes. Lady has to be true. So that's not the case. So let's put a little X next to it. Let's try this one. Empty room, well, doesn't really matter what that says. Room three is empty. It's false, but I don't really know what it should be. It could be either one. Room two, the tiger is in room one. That is false. Room three, this room is empty. What do I conclude?
Not true.
Not true? Again, the lady is the problem. Okay. Work our way up, it doesn't matter. Room one. Room three is empty. No. Do I need to do any more? No. Because this can't happen. The room that the lady is in has to have a true statement, and it doesn't. So that's not happening. So I don't necessarily have to fill in everything. As soon as it fails in one, the rest doesn't matter. This one. Room one has a tiger, and room one says that room three is empty. That is false. Room three has a lady in this scenario. Room two says the tiger is in room one. That's true, but it doesn't really matter. Room three says, this room is empty. Conclusion?
It's false.
False because of this lady. Lady can't have a false statement. Almost there. Room one has a lady. Room one says, room three is empty. That's true. Room two has a tiger, and room two says the tiger is in room one. False. Room three is empty, and it doesn't really matter what it's in. This room is empty, yeah, it's true. What do I conclude? Good? Everything checks. We have one more to do, so let's make sure. Room one has a tiger and it says room three is empty. That's true. Do I need to go any further?
No.
No, because the tiger needs to have a false statement and this one is true. So that can't happen. So this is the one. So let's say here choose room one for the lady.
Choose two.
Room, okay. Room two for
a horrible death.
Death by tiger. Room three for, I don't know,
solitude.
For solitude.
I get it.